Hello everyone, welcome back to Star Education, and in this video we are continuing our chapter 1 of class 9 maths NCERT with exercise 1.3. First of all, I want to request you to please like my videos, comment on it how you like it, and subscribe my channel, and also don't forget to press the bell icon. So let's start with question number 1. What's question number 1? In question number 1 it's given that we have to write the following in decimal form, and we have to also tell what kind of decimal expansion each has. How we will write it in decimal form? By dividing it, and we have to tell whether these are terminating or non-terminating. In this we will do 4 questions. There are 6, we will do 4. We will do 1st, 2nd, 3rd and 6th. And if you have any problem in 4th and 5th in doing 4th and 5th question, you can also ask me in the comment section. I'll tell you how to do this. So let's first start with our first question, 36/100. Now what we will do is, we will write it in this form, the numerator inside and the denominator outside. Now we will divide it simply as 36 is smaller than 100, so we will put a 0 and point here, and we will add a 0 here. So now 360 is greater than 100, so we can easily divide it. 100, 3s are 300, and remainder comes as 60. So we will again put a 0 because we are having a point here, and 6s are 600. As the remainder comes 0, and we are having the quotient, so the quotient is the answer. We write here answer as 0.2636, and we have to also tell what kind of decimal expansion it has. So it is a terminating number, as the quotient is not repeating itself. Yes, it's so that it's a terminating decimal. Now let's move to the second part, 1/11. Again we have written, sorry, I have done a mistake here. 11 will come outside as it is the denominator, so 11 will come outside. Here we will write 11, and the 1 will come, as it is the numerator, it will come inside. So let's divide it. 1 is smaller than 11, so we'll put a 0 here and point and a 0 here. Then also it is smaller than 11, so what we will do is, we will put a 0 here and here. Now 11 9s are 99. We know that this process will continue. Again we will put 2 zeros here, then again 9s are 99. So we will not do the further division. We will only write that the answer is, we will only write that the answer is 0.09 bar, which means infinite times, and as it is infinite, so it is a non-terminating and repeating, non-terminating and repeating term. We have done 2 questions. Now the left are third part, 4/1/8. Now let's do this question. First of all, we will convert 4/1/8 into its, as it is a whole fraction, so we will convert it into the proper fraction. Now we will divide it, and the answer comes as 4.125, and it is a terminating decimal. I have done this question. You can take the screenshots, or you can pause the video and understand the question. And if you have any problem in this question, you may tell me in the comment section. Same way we will do this question also, and the answer will be 0.8225 terminating. It is a terminating term. 3 to 29/400, the answer is 0.8225, and it is a terminating term. Again you can ask me in the comment section, or you can take the screenshots to understand this. So we have done all the 4 parts of exercise 1.3. now let's move to question 2. You know that 1/7 is equal to 0.142857. can you predict what the decimal expansion of 2/7, 3/7, 4/7, 5/7, 6/7 are without actually doing the long division method? If so, how? We don't have to do the long division method, but we have to tell what are the decimal expansions of these. For this, we don't have to do the decimal expansion. So what we will do is, we will multiply them. How? like this. You can see in the question as 1 upon 7 equal to this. So 2 upon 7 will be equal to 2 into 1 upon 7, which is equal to 2 into 0.142857, and we will get our answer. Same way, we will multiply 3 upon 7, 4 by 7, 5 by 7 and 6 by 7 also to get our answers. These are 5 answers. Now let's move to question number 3. What is given in the question that we have to write the following in the form of P upon Q, where P and Q are integers and Q is not equal to 0. We will do the first and second part. The third part you can take as your homework or you will do it yourself. So this is the third question. Now let's understand it. The question is 0.6 bar. So we will put X is equal to 0.666666. Now if this is equal to this, now the bar is on one number, so we will add one number here, zero here, and now we will put here x. 10x is equal to 6.666. now 10x is equal to 6 plus x, because we have written here it's 6 plus x. Yes, now 10x, we will take it here, we will take it to this side, and as it is positive, by coming at a positive side, it will subtract. 10 minus x is equal to 6. 10x minus 1x is equal to 9x is equal to 6. Now as it is in a multiplication here, then we will take it to the division. 6 3 2 is a 6 and 3 3 is a 9, and our answer is 2 upon 3. Now let's move to the second question, that is 0.47. This is the question. Let's understand this. 1x is equal to 0.474747 as in the previous question. Now 10x is equal to 4.474747 and 100x is equal to 47.474747. And now 100x is equal to 47 minus 4, which is equal to 43 plus 10x plus 10x. Now 100x is equal to 43 plus 10x. We will take it to the subtraction this side, and 100x minus 10x is equal to 43. 90x is equal to 43 and x will be equal to 43 upon 90. You can also see the third part. If your answer is correct, then please like my video and comment on it what you have got as your answer. This is the third part I have solved for you. This is same as we have done in the first and second part. Now let's move to question number 4. It's the same type of question. We have to express 0.99999 in the form of P upon Q. Are you surprised by your answer? So let's do this. This is the same type of question, so I have done it here. Please have a look or take a screenshot. It's same and the answer will be 1. And you can write your statement. Yes, we are surprised at our answer, but the answer makes sense, because when we observe that 0.9999 goes on forever, so there is no gap between 1 and 0.9999, hence they are equal. Now question 5 and question 6. Guys, see, these type of questions do not come in exam, but if you want to do these, you can do, but in this video we will not discuss them. Okay, we will directly move to question number 7. Write 3 numbers whose decimal expansions are non-terminating and non-recurring. This is your homework. You know what are non-terminating or non-recurring numbers, so you will write 3 examples of that. Now coming to question number 8. Find 3 irrational numbers between the rational numbers 5 upon 7 and 9 upon 11. So in this question, first of all, we will write 5 upon 7 and 9 upon 11 in decimal form, because we have to find irrational numbers. So I have written it in the form of decimal, where 5 upon 7 is equal to 0.714285 and 9 by 11 is equal to 0.81. And I have written these 3 rational numbers between the following numbers. You can write, there are n number of rational numbers, so you can write any, and you can also write the answers which are given on the back of the book, but I have written these answers, and these are my answer. Now let's move to next question. Question 9. Classify the following numbers as irrational or rational. We have to classify whether the following are irrational or rational. Let's see the first part. In the first part, the question is root 23. It's absolutely not irrational, because it is not a perfect square. 23 is not a perfect square of any number, so it is irrational. Root 2 to 5 is rational, because it is a perfect square. 0.3796 is also a rational number. 7.478478 and so on is also a rational number. 1.101001001001 and so on is irrational numbers because they are repeating. Now we have completed this whole exercise today, exercise 1.3, and you have understood the video, I suppose. And if you have liked the video, then please like my video, subscribe my channel, and don't forget to press the bell icon. Till then, stay home, stay safe. Goodbye.